This is Roy of Kick of Legend, here with Peter at Michigan Kickboxing Academy once again, and we're going to continue our kick counters to the punching with countering the right cross with three timings and both sides of the kick. So, right kick and left kick against the right cross, full beat, half beat, and on the beat. Here we go. Corkscrew into the leg, or I can parry and step into the right kick. Or I can even go parry and kind of run through and kick his rear leg. But what's cool about that is it's a little bit unexpected, right? He's not going to think about that too often, so especially given that his weight is kind of perhaps ambiguous as he's transferring between the punch. If I catch that on the full beat, that can still work. If I want to catch it on the half beat, corkscrew on the leg. So we're going to go one and. And if I want to catch it on the beat, just kick. Or just kick. Right? Your kicking motion is going to take you past his punch into an area of safety, which is why this works on the beat. If you're a little bit fuzzy on that, you can parry it as well and hit it on the half beat. To use the left kick to counter the right cross, I have fairly similar options. We're going to parry out, kick the rear leg. So it comes in, parry, one. I can switch on the parry, throw it out as I come up, and then kick. Once again, on this side. And then on the beat, lean back, hit that inner leg. It's a shoulder roll, right? On this side. We're going to shoulder roll with that left kick or hit the body. Again, on the beat, sometimes hard to catch him with the left kick if you have to switch first. So just kind of rolling back has some decent options. Especially if you work the left kick without a switch on the tie pads, which I highly recommend you do. Now that we've covered the basic variations, we're going to drill it out a little bit. So we're going to feed. Jab. Jab, and I'll return the right cross, and he'll do one of the three. And then he'll feed, one, two, three. And I'm going to take on the beat, half beat, or full beat, depending on what I happen to catch and what happens to be in my head at that time. One, two, three, good. One, two, three. Now that we've got a handle on that, we're going to mix it up a little bit by feeding either one, or two, or one, two. And you'll notice this is going to make the drill 10 times harder because even though I've only got two or three choices, not knowing which one is coming is really going to test how well I really know this technique and how much it's really in my body. You notice that on the cross, he was already out of the way. Didn't even hit him. That's exactly what we want. Good. So, as you can see, we got some rust to shake off ourselves, but I hope that communicated to you the basic idea of countering the jab with your kicks. You want to make sure you have this in your body, so if someone's really stinging you a lot with his punches, or you have to make up a range gap because his arms are longer than yours, kick counters are a great way to shut it down. We don't always catch the kick right into our partner's torso or leg. Sometimes we end up still hitting his arm. That's fine. Remember, if you're kicking hard, that's still punishing him. That's still making him think, keep my arm at defense rather than on your face. This is Roy with Kick of Legend with Peter here at Michigan Kickboxing Academy. Remember, keep your chin down, elevate your striking.